Hi, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And today I'm going to start with a new series. It's Big Data and Hadoop. And this is the first video. In this particular video, I'm not going to tell you what exactly the Big Data is, what exactly the Hadoop is. I'm just going to start with the installation portion. The first thing that we need to remember is normally the people having the Windows operating system, and for Hadoop, even we can install the Hadoop with the Windows also. But for the Hadoop, the good thing is we should have Linux with our system. And if I need to install the Linux with the Windows, it's again the challenging task. So first of all, what we need to do, we need to install the Linux within the Windows. So in this particular video, I'm going to install the Linux with Windows 10. Now, if you want to install the Linux with Windows 10, what we need to do? Basically, we require the two things over there. The first thing is a virtual box. It's a virtual box. And this virtual box is also known as VB. It's a virtual box. And the second thing we need to install is Ubuntu. We need to install the Ubuntu. First of all, we need to understand what exactly the virtual box is, and then we need to understand what exactly the Ubuntu is, and after that we will go with the installation of the virtual box and we will go with the installation of the Ubuntu. First of all, if I'm talking about the virtual box, what exactly the virtual box is? It's basically a software package. It's a kind of software virtualization package that install on an operating system as an application. So basically, what exactly the virtual box is, it's a kind of software virtualization package that install on an operating system as an application. And this particular VB and the virtual box, it allow us to install another operating system as a guest operating system. So virtual box is what? Basically, it's a kind of software package that install on an operating system, and that particular operating system means virtual box. It allows us to install the another operating system as a guest OS, guest operating system. This virtual box was developed by Innotech GmbH. And released in 2007 as an open source. Initially, it was the open source. Later on, this get purchased by the Sun Microsystem, and after that the Sun Microsystem purchased by Oracle Corporation. So now this virtual box is basically, it's a product by Oracle. It's a software package, and the title of this is Oracle VM Virtual Box. It's basically Oracle VM Virtual Box. So first of all, what we need to do, we need to install the Oracle VM. Now, the second thing is, after the installation of Oracle VM, the virtual box, what we need to do, we need to install the Linux operating system over there, because we are working with At present, we are working with this Windows 10. In this particular PC, I'm having the Windows 10. And what I need to do, I need to install the VirtualBox first. And after the VirtualBox, we need to install the Ubuntu. So what exactly the Ubuntu is? First of all, what we need to learn, what we need to understand, it's basically kind of Ubuntu is a distribution. It's a distribution, or also known as distro. In Linux lingo, basically, distribution is stand for version. Distribution is a version of the operating system. So Ubuntu is basically what? It's a distribution, or also known as distro of Linux. And in Linux language, what exactly the distribution stand for? Distribution is basically it's a version of the operating system. This Ubuntu is basically it's a product by company called Canonical. This is the company. The Ubuntu is a product by this particular company, and the purpose of this particular company is to provide free open source. Basically, this particular company provides the free operating system for the user. You don't need to purchase the license and all. That you don't need to do. What exactly we need to do? We just need to install the operating system. It's free of cost. We don't need to purchase the license. The basic thing is that basically Ubuntu, it's a kind of operating system. And the core of this operating system is Linux kernel. So it's based on Linux kernel. Other than this Ubuntu, we are having the different product in the market. And the other products are, these products are equally popular. And other product we can install is Manjaro. This is the product we are having. Manjaro. We are having Mint. We are having Elementary. And we are having MX Linux. So these are the different variants that we can use. So it's not necessary that I will go for the Ubuntu. Even other than the Ubuntu, you can go for the Manjaro, you can go for the Mint, you can go for the Elementary, you can go for the MX Linux. So the two things are there. The first thing, we need to install the VirtualBox. And the second thing, we need to install the Ubuntu. Now I'm going to start the installation of the VirtualBox, how we can do that. So first of all, what I need to do, I'm going to open the browser over there. And now I'm writing VirtualBox installation. VirtualBox download. And I'm just going to click on this download Oracle VM VirtualBox. Now, basically, with my system, it's Windows operating system is there. On the Windows operating system, I need to install the VirtualBox. If Linux is there, I will go for the Linux distribution. What I need to do, I'm going to start with the Windows host. So we just need to click on this window. The installation will get start. It's already installed with my system, so I'm just going to make it cancel. So the first thing, I'm just going to open the download section. In my download, it's Oracle VM is there. This VirtualBox is there. And the second thing that we need to install is Ubuntu. So again, I'm going to install the Ubuntu. So I'm just writing Ubuntu download and click on this. The different variants are there. This one is the latest release, Ubuntu 18.04.2 LTS. And I'm just going to download this. These are the recommended system requirements for the Ubuntu. I'm just going to download this. And after clicking on this download, it will get it will start the downloading over there. And the file size, it will start downloading. It's 1.9 GB size is there. Just I'm going to make it cancel. It will also ask you for contribute with the PayPal. So you can also even contribute with them. Like $15, this is the sample amount. Even you can write $100, $1,000, that's not a problem. So if you want to contribute with the Ubuntu operating system, you can contribute your amount over there. I'm just joking. I'm just going to close this. Now the software get installed. This one is the Ubuntu and this one is the VirtualBox. Now what I need to do, I just need to click on this VirtualBox. And it's going to start the installation. VirtualBox, welcome to the Oracle VM VirtualBox. Click on the next. It's already installed with my system, so I don't need to reinstall it. It is asking for repair the things or asking for the remove. I'm not going to remove it, and everything is fine, so I'm not going to repair it. So what exactly you need to do, you just need to click on the next finish, it will get installed. The first thing, the VirtualBox get installed with my system. Now, this is your Oracle VM VirtualBox. Now I need to click on this. This is the environment. Now, in this particular VirtualBox environment, what we can do, we can install the other operating system over there. So how we can do that? For this, what we need to do, I'm just going to click on this new. And I'm just going to give the name over there, like name and operating system. And I'm going to give the name, like this is my Ubuntu. So I'm just going to give the name Ubuntu. So it will be easier for me to remember the things. So I'm just going to give the name like Ubuntu over there. And what machine folder, it will get installed in this particular folder. And what operating system I need to install? I need to install the Linux. I will go for the Linux. And this is the versions we are having. Click on the next. Now it is asking for me to assign the RAM. Because in this particular system, it's only 4 GB RAM is there. So maximum, it's allow me for this level. Even I can also increase the size. I'm going to give like 204. Right? Ideally, it should be 4 GB. That will be better. At present, I'm just going to assign the 2 GB because it's only 4 GB is with my system. So it should be ideally 2 GB. So I'm just going to do that and click on the next. What we need to do now, it is asking for the hard disk. The recommended size of the hard disk is 10 GB. Just leave it. It's more than enough. I'm just going to create a virtual hard disk now. Click on this, create. And I need to click on this virtual box disk image. Next, storage on the physical hard disk, it's dynamically allocated. And again, file location and the size. And I'm going to create that. Now, every configuration information is available over here. Now what I need to do, I just need to click on this start. When I will click on this start, now it is asking for select the startup disk. Because my setup is available with the download folder, so I'm just going to click on this. And I'm going to click on, in this my PC, it's Ubuntu. Like this version, desktop version is available with me. I'm just going to click on this, start. Now it's going to install the Ubuntu over there. it will take some time. I'm just going to show you the step what we need to do now. Now it's going to start. Remember, for the Hadoop, the Linux is the best platform. And to install the Linux with the Windows, what we need to do? At first, we need to install the VirtualBox. And the second thing, I'm going to start with the virtual Ubuntu over there. Now the installation is going to start. Now it is asking me, either I can try the Ubuntu, or we can install the Ubuntu. I'm going to install the Ubuntu. These are the different languages. Now, I'm going to use the English US. English US over there. Again, continue. This is the keyboard layout. Now, either we can go for the normal installation or we can go for the minimal installation. I'm going for the normal installation. With the normal installation, a lot of things will be there, like web browser, some utilities, office softwares, media players, a lot of things will be there. I'm just going to with the normal installation. And this download update while installing Ubuntu, it's not required for me. Just remove this. Continue. Now, this is really the good options we are having. This computer currently has no detected operating system. Talking about the virtual machine, virtual box. Now what you need to do, you just need to click on this. It has disk and install Ubuntu. Remember, this one is the virtual things. So it's not going to erase your data from the your hard disk. So you don't need to worry about that. Like it's not going to remove your data from the E drive or D drive or from C drive. So just I'm going to click on this erase disk and install Ubuntu. Install now. Now, click on this, continue. Even at present, what we can do, okay. I'm going to select the time zone. Continue. I'm just going to give my name over there, like Santosh. So your computer name is Santosh-VirtualBox. Pick the username, it's Santosh is there. And I'm going to give the password like ABCD. Again, I'm going to give the password like ABCD. Require my password to log in. Otherwise, you can also use login automatically. And I'm just going to click on this continue. It's starting the copying the files. In the meantime, you can get some information regarding the Ubuntu, what exactly the things is. At first, it's going to copy the file. See, it's not necessary for me to install the Ubuntu. It's not necessary for me to install the Oracle Virtual Box. Even we can also install the Hadoop system with the Windows operating system with Windows 10. But in the industry, in the market, what exactly is going on? Hadoop with Linux. So if we want to learn the big data, normally in the big data, we need to start with the Hadoop. A lot of things are there. And for the Hadoop, exactly the Linux is the most suitable environment. That's why we are going to start with the Linux. This is the first video. We are talking about the VirtualBox installation, Ubuntu installation, so that the everything, the platform will get ready for you. In the next session, in the next video, I will discuss about the basic Linux command that is required for the Hadoop. Because every time in the Hadoop, you need to write a lot of commands over there. So it's really necessary for us to get the familiar with the Linux basic command. So in the next video, we will go with the Linux basic command. Just wait, it's going on. A lot of people ask me about the configuration of the Hadoop system. See, for the Hadoop system, naturally, it's required the latest one. The latest system should be there. at the time of installation, just you need to remember, like for the Ubuntu, just give the 4 GB RAM space over there minimum. And for the hard disk space, just give the 10 GB. It will work for you. Now the installation gets started. Installing system. Initially the copy get applied over there. It takes lesser time than Windows 10. Normally, in ideal scenario, it takes lesser time than the Windows 10. Yeah, it's installing over there. Good thing about the Ubuntu is basically you will get the GUI environment over there. In the GUI environment, like the Windows, like the Mac operating system, you will get the GUI environment over there. The graphical user interface environment will be there. So, and you feel comfortable with the environment more or less. But basically in Ubuntu, from the Hadoop prospect, what we need to do? The most important thing, we need to remember the commands and all. We need to do the practice with the terminals. In Ubuntu, the terminal will be there. At the terminal, you can write down the command and you can execute that. Installation is going on, so just you need to wait. In the next video, I will discuss about the basic commands of the Linux operating system. After that, we will start with the big data and Hadoop session. In the introductory video, we will start with the big data. What exactly the big data is, why it is called big data. See, this is the time, this is the era for the internet. In today's scenario, like, can you imagine what volumes of data get generated every second by the social media? Can you imagine what volumes of data get generated by the share market every seconds? What about the sensor data? What about the webcam? What about the scientific calculations and all? What about the search engine? So in today's scenario, it's really important for us as an IT professional. We need to understand what exactly the big data is, how to manage the big data, because this is going to be the future. It's going to be the future in the industry. If we have to survive in the industry, you should learn the big data. You should learn the Hadoop. Because it's a market trend now. It's not only the Hadoop. Hadoop is simply a part of, like, it's a kind of technology for implementation of big data and analytics over there. Other than the big data, other than the Hadoop, even for this, Python is also there that we need to understand. So a lot of things are there in today's scenario in the industry. Lot of operating system, lot of things are there that we need to understand. It's taking too much time. Yeah, we'll take. We can't do anything. You can change the appearance and all, like Windows operating system. A lot of things are there. Included software will be like Office Writer, Office Calculator. A lot of things will be there. You will get the like Firefox is also there. Supported software. These are the supported software you can use over there. Even for the photo manager, it's also there. So a lot of things are there. Even the music player is also there. So this is just the another or like this is simply the another operating system. Like earlier, Windows are there with me, like Linux, and Ubuntu is basically what? It's basically distro of Linux. Distro means what? A distribution of Linux. Distribution means it's a version we are talking about. It's not necessary for me to install the Ubuntu itself. But other than Ubuntu, other softwares are also there that we can install, like Manjaro, Mint, Elementary, MX Linux, that we can install over there. See, we are getting this message, this pop-up is there. Like the virtual machine report, the guest operating system support mouse pointer integration. Like your mouse get installed with this. I'm just going to close this. This is also auto capture keyword option turn on. This will cause the virtual machine to automatically capture the keyboard every time. So a lot of things are there. Right now it's downloading the language pack. Lot of utilities are there. It's going on. This one is the good information. At the time of installation, we can just go through this just to get familiar about the Ubuntu. What exactly is that? This is the first steps towards the Hadoop or big data. We need to install the Linux, and for the Linux, what we need to do? We need to install the VirtualBox and we need to install the Ubuntu. Installation is taking too much time. That's why I'm waiting for that. I can also okay, it's going on. Just wait for 5 to 10 seconds. Okay, in the meantime, the installation is going on. In the meantime, what we can discuss about the Ubuntu. Like, you can ask me the question, what is the difference between the Linux and Ubuntu? This is really the genuine questions for the beginners. What is the difference between Ubuntu and the Linux? Or how the Ubuntu is linked with the Linux. Even in my video title, it was Ubuntu/Linux. So what does it mean? See, for this, we need to understand the two things. There is the different types of operating systems are there in the market. Installation is complete. You need to start the computer in order to use the new installation. Remember, it will restart the virtual machine only. It will not restart your complete Windows. See, basically there is two types of operating systems are there. One is like from the Microsoft, one is from like Apple. For that you just need to press the enter over there. I'm just going to click enter. See, there is two types of operating system. One is for that you need to purchase the license and all, like Windows, like Mac operating system. And one is the open source. The open source operating system like Windows are there. Sorry, the Linux are there. Open source means what? The source code will be there with you. Source code means what? Like Ubuntu. Ubuntu is basically what? Ubuntu is the operating system. And this particular operating system is based with Linux kernel. Okay, finally, we are having the Windows. Now what I need to do? This is my virtual environment. Now what I need to do? I need to start this. I'm just going to click on this. I need to give the password over there. I'm going to give the password and sign in. Now this is your Linux environment. Yeah, it's going to come. Now this is your Linux environment. You can learn about these things. What exactly is this? This is your apps button. This is your doc folder. This is your Windows switcher. Like applications menu, a lot of things are there. Just click on next, next, next. Done. This is your environment for Ubuntu. Now what we can do, a lot of things are there. We can click on this. Ubuntu softwares, like this is your LibreOffice. This is just like Microsoft Office. Even the Word document will be there. You can write the documents and all. I'm just going to close this. Now the important thing what we need to do, see, a lot of things are there. The most important thing that we need to understand is terminal. We need to open the terminal. Now this is your Linux environment. Now you can write down your command and you can start your work. So this is all about the virtual box and Ubuntu installation. Now your system is ready. Now you can start with your Linux command. In the next video, I will discuss about that. Thanks a lot.